Hi guys, today's going to be a topic or a short video about a topic that's actually pretty important and it's important to everybody. It's about lights. Everybody that rides during the day and during the night, obviously they require some lights at the back and at the front. The lights differ, obviously, depending on the quality of the light that you buy. They go from anything from 150 lumens to a crazy 2,000, 5,000 lumens. Then they also, for the road, you need something like 1,000, 1,200 lumens, and that's pretty much a spot that illuminates just the road ahead of you. And then that's at night. You only want to use a spot during the night, no flashy light, because it's going to blind you, it's going to give you an epileptic attack, and the motorists and other cyclists come towards you. So a spot is up to sunrise, and sun has risen already, and then use the flashy lights. Also, if you're going to use a flashy light, try use the one dedicated for flashy, in a wider surface area that allow you to use it. It's not going to be such a pain in the eye. Same thing goes for your rear. You don't use one of those dim littered LEDs, all cheapos, for the back of your bike. You can only see it at like 5 meters away from you. You need something that you can see from up to 200 meters away. Anything up to there, it's brilliant. Lights itself, if you just want to do road riding, so it's 1,000 lumen, that's fine. All you need to see the road ahead of you, nothing else like that. But if you're going to decide to do trail riding, mountain biking, you need something more with a punch. Now obviously, the more the higher the lumen ratio, the more it's going to cost you. So lights can set you back anything from front lights, that is, can set you back anything from 400-500 rand up to about 2,500 rand, depends where you buy. You can go to Chris Willems Cycles and Extreme Lights, and I'll put the links in the bottom, and then you can see what I'm talking about when it comes to lights, front lights, and also rear lights. You get different types, and you get the ones look like this little stick, something like this. It goes to your seat post and it flashes. Red, strobes red, and solid light red, and then you get the round ones like this. All of my USB rechargeable. This one's pretty cool, and then this one actually, it has an SOS feature. So if you're on a trail at night and you land yourself in trouble, they can see you flashing SOS with these lights. What makes this little light great? It flashes white and red at the same time. So it's red, red, white, white, red, red, white, white. And I use this for the front of the bike, and actually cars see me a lot better. They actually see the white and the red flashing and they think there's some trouble coming. They get out the way for me. The whole idea is not to blind them, it's just to be noticed. Front lights, guys, you can get anything, like I said before, from 150 lumens up to 2,500 lumens. But depending on the type of riding you're going to obviously do. Everybody has seen and maybe have some of these. This is my 900,000 lumens front light, and they all come with a battery bank like this. These are 18650 batteries. They're a lot bigger than the AA's. Actually, one of these is going to 4 AA's, and they 3.7 volt, and at 4,500 milliamp hour, so they last you quite a bit. Now obviously the quality of these batteries also changes, and obviously so does the price. That's just for road riding. I bought one of these tube torches that can be mounted on your frame, also on your bike with a screw mount, and this is anything from a 1 lumen to 5,000 lumens. And also, again, it takes us 4 18650 batteries. At 5,000 lumens, it lasts 90 minutes, and at 1,500 lumens, lasts me 6 hours. And this is more of a spreader instead of a spot. When you road riding, you need a spot, and when you go trail riding and mountain biking, you need a spread, which actually illuminates the ground, the sides, and on top, and it's so bright you can see every rock, every crevice, every donga if you want, and it's actually very, very, very bright. They do get smaller than this and they get more compact, but these are self-contained batteries, so you don't have to worry about carrying an extra battery bank with you. And another one is quite important when you go night riding is to have a headlight or head torch. It goes on top of your helmet. Just remember, your light shines where your handlebars are pointing. Now, if you're riding somewhere you don't know what's on the side of you, a headlamp is quite handy because it actually can look at certain areas where your handlebars aren't going. So it's pretty cool. This one's nice. It has a torch. And it has red lights on the side as well as to the flashies and stuff like that. So yeah, no, lights are very, very important. During the day, you should ride lights back and front, flashy ones in the front. Don't go killer on the lumens. Go maybe 250, 300 lumens in the front. If you go early morning, say 6 o'clock, and it's just about light, you don't need to know where you're going because you can see it's not that dark, but the car still need to see you. As for the rear, use a flashy light, they can see you. The reason why flashy lights, I prefer red and white, is because it grabs people's attention. If you just have a white one, that's fine. Put an orange film over the lens or the light itself, and it gets the attention much better. So yeah, lights front and back always. Don't use the most powerful ones for flashy during the night because it's gonna blind you and everybody else. And don't use the super bright ones for flashy during the day. If you do only have that light, dip them so they don't hit you immediately in your eye, but they do see the flash coming from a distance. Everybody should have a light. Invest in a good set of lights, front and back, and they will last you a long time. Especially the back ones, they're not that expensive. A good pair I've seen for about 250 bucks, I think. And I've seen some that actually has got a gravity sensor or a G sensor built into them, a gyro sensor. So if you brake, you hold onto your brakes, actually they illuminate a lot brighter. And when you if you stop braking, they go back to normal red, which is quite clever. I've seen them in the Chinese stores and all jazz, but they should be available around here. So guys, just be responsible. It's your life at the end of the day. Let people know where you are, and if you have done that and they've seen you, you saved your life and somebody else's life for that matter. Invest in a good pair of lights, or get a good set of lights. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Just on the bottom, again at the bottom, I'll put all the links for some of the lights we can actually have a look at, and also if you like the channel, subscribe, and then I'll see you guys again on the trail. You guys have a great day. Bye.